What's your favorite? Who's your favorite guitar player? Let's get to your musical influences. Do you have a favorite guitar player?
Yes, well, as far as musical influences are concerned, Sting is my idol. Complete institution in music, I think. Okay, how many of us love Sting out here? Let me check. Okay.
Who doesn't like Sting? Yeah. No, just kidding.
That'll be heartbreaking for me, yeah. But truly, I think musicians like that.
You never thought of picking up the bass then? Sting's famous for his bass playing, of course?
No, I did not. No, I think for me, a string instrument, the acoustic guitar especially, is so warm and organic, it sounds. Yeah, I mean, there are a lot of guitar players like Steve Lukather. I mean, I can never ever even think of playing like Steve Lukather. But yeah, I admire those kind of guitar players. Just so.
And what about from a compositional point of view? Not just, you know, famous music or Bollywood music directors, but even outside North America or other world music that you might listen to. Who do you like and who has inspired you when you first started out as an artist that you think it's still sort of finding its way into your music right now?
You know, well, as far as world music is concerned, we have a very talented person called Nitin Sawhney in UK. I just completely love the way he composes music and gets music together. I mean, he's
a lot of fusion music, so...
And fusion music is something which I completely trip on. Of course, for me, A.R. Rahman is one of the greatest composers and music producers, as I would really put it, because he's been path-breaking. We all know that.
You do is you're also, as an artist, active in politics in different ways. One, for instance, from the terrorist attacks that happened in India a few months back, you released a song, a single, and now that seems like that would be completely free of the whole chain of the Bollywood pressures. So how important was it for you to not just get that song out, but just in general to be involved in politics?
I don't know about politics, but I would say socially active,
right.
Social service, because since we are known, we can set a lot of examples on people and it becomes our social responsibility to take up a cause. Terrorism problem began, especially in November. You know, when it happens in remote areas, maybe people like us don't get so affected. But we were hit hard when it happened in the city of Mumbai. And people like you and me just lost their lives for nothing. And that's what really, really shook me up, shattered me and many other people. And I think it was very, very important to do a song to bid farewell to those innocent lives that we lost. And secondly, very important to keep a reminder that this can happen. So we really need to be very agile, very alert. And security as it is an issue in our country. So we need to really fight terrorism.
Another important cause I think you've been involved with is with women's rights and the young female children as well.
Yes, yes.
Why don't you tell, that's something that's coming up still, I believe, right? So we're going to see a peek on this.
You know, on International Women's Day, which is 8th of March, I was invited by the President of India to the President's House, Rashtrapati Bhavan, and we were all made to take an oath to save the girl child. And I think it's really important because if you look into the study, the statistics and the survey, it's ghastly what you learn, you know. The amount of, baby girls which are killed, it's horrific. So I'm working on a song again. I can do it through music. So I'm doing a song where I would talk about this cause. And
so can you sum up a little advice for anyone who's thinking, I want to be headlining NMN in 2 years or 3 years? What would you tell them to do to get their music career off?
I think you need to really work on your originality. Never copy another singer or another artist because, you know, we need to hear what is so special about you. You, the artist that you are. And just work on your strength and keep polishing your skill. I think, you know, what goes wrong is when reality singer contestants suddenly become winners and they become the catapult into fame instantly. And that's when they don't know how to handle it. And it takes a long time to actually sustain yourself. So even if you get the opportunity to become famous, it's more hard to actually, you know, hold on and sustain it. So it's important to actually first keep polishing your skill, working on your music, working on yourself as an artist, singer, composer, writer, whatever you want to do. The day you feel that, okay, I think I'm one of the best, that's the day you know you can actually say, I'm going to take a dive into the job.